Jenny, give us the intro.
And this is episode
5.
5, 8 hours later. I'm Eugenie.
I'm Bernard.
Kevin.
And I'm Steve Avitable, an actor guy.
All right, so our producer.
Episode 5. Let's talk about episode 5, Bernard. How did this come about?
All right.
What was it supposed to be?
It was supposed to be a musical for the longest time, and we worked with a lot of different people, a lot of talented people, but it just never kind of came together. So I was just like, Kev, if need be, I'll just write an episode real quick. And we wrote this episode.
We spent about a few days on the story.
A few days on the story. I wrote it in like a day or two. Gave it to you. We reviewed it.
And then we got this together. And honestly, I can't imagine this episode as a musical anymore.
No, this is.
This is probably my favorite episode because we. Just the way it turned out and the way we wrote it and everything. It was just. I don't know. It was great. I love this.
Yeah, it's very self contained. It's like it's an episode that could be like it pushes the main story, but this is just like a thing that happens to them, and that's what I like most about this story.
It's also the funny. I think it's the funniest episode out of all of them. Just the moments it has. And stuff.
Yeah. Just talking about all this 8mm app stuff. We shot this on the iPhone. It was just me and Wendy just kind of hanging out for like one night, going around LA. That song, by the way, was April Chase. Great band from San Jose. Really great band. Okay. Check them out.
Let's talk about spaghetti.
Okay. So,
no, what are you doing?
A lot of people are like, what the hell is it? Like, it is in the script. We kept wanting to put this. It was going to be in the musical if it was going to be in the musical. But it's from my favorite movie, The Apartment.
Never have to make spaghetti.
Oh, man. He does it. The Jack Lemmon does it. To Shirley MacLaine, he's like cooking her spaghetti, and then he throws it on a tennis racket and then puts it on a plate, and he does it so smooth, so much smoother than I do it. And Shirley MacLaine,
you were trying
like,
to do it smoothly at first, but it was funnier than we were messing up.
It looked better when I like just messed it up.
It was funny because I think the first take you did, you were like, "Ah, man," and everyone was like, "That was funny. That looked good when you messed up."
But your guys' chemistry here is just—it's the best. And I mean, we shot this probably 2-3 months after all the other episodes. And just everyone in this episode just
I'm really nervous
just really brings it. It's really great. Great. Great.
It is pretty great. No, I honestly think a lot of people's best performances were in this one because we had already done all the other.
That's why I think if the viewers out there are spread out to enough people and we do everything, our second season can just be 8 more episodes of kind of like this kind of caliber stuff.
Yeah, like think how much better this episode is compared to other ones, you know, performance-wise and editing and all that.
Yeah.
And it'll just get better.
Turnaround's really quick. Happened, but
yeah. We did this in about, what, 2 weeks, Maroon?
Yeah. 2 weeks from like, oh my god, we gotta do an episode.
From writing to shooting to actually edit it in about 2 weeks.
Yeah.
It was quick. That's why
you can see. You can actually see the difference of my character because I put on weight.
Did you?
I did.
How much weight?
I don't know, like 10 pounds.
I was weighty in the beginning. I didn't want to say anything.
You were weighty in the beginning?
Yeah, I was heavy in the beginning. When I was wearing
that headband
I was trying
like
to hide my
pounds.
Weight.
I'll see you later.
Did anybody else gain or lose weight between all the other episodes and this one?
I think I lost a bunch of weight.
You lost a bunch? Yeah, Adam. Pat, like if you look at him now, man, that guy's like, he was telling me.
He looks great now.
I feel like I was probably the same. I had lost all my weight before we started filming anything.
You were just working on that chest for the nude scene.
He looked good when we were doing it, but I noticed he lost a lot of weight.
So, as you guys can see, we go right back to the paper towels.
That was, we found that to be actually, people really liked that, responded to that. But it ended up being a through line throughout the whole series, which we really love.
Yeah, and Steve, you got a lot of comments, right?
Yeah.
From a lot of people about paper towels.
Oh, yeah. A lot of people are like, dude, just get them the paper towel. Stop being an ass about it. You're being so mean.
We have a big following in New Hampshire because of Steve.
Yeah.
From the Shire.
There's all everyone from the Shire.
Okay.
This is a good scene.
So this guy came.
Only scene I wasn't here to shoot.
This it was good you weren't here. This is that's Jonathan Mackey. John Mackey. He's from Upright Citizens Brigade. Yeah, we all had me, Eugenie, and John all had class together. And he we needed a guy to come in. I think I asked him maybe 3 days before this. I wrote him in, and you're like, I don't know who to get. You're like, do you know anybody? I was like, yeah, I know the perfect guy. We should get John Mackey. And when we shot this, there's so much stuff that we don't use. It's great. Like, it's a, yeah. And I couldn't hold it.
That's why I thought this was
Yeah. Also,
and Steve was doing sound on this.
Kevin Hinman, sound master, wasn't able to be here, so he had to train me the day before to do sound on this. It was so hard not to laugh. And, like, I was so afraid I was going to mess up a take, but as soon as Bernard started laughing, I know I could laugh. Because, and he laughs, like, we all laugh so much. Because just the improv this guy was doing was so funny.
I should give him some credit. John, he sent, I sent him the script, and I was like, change whatever you want. Just make sure we hit these things. And he made these changes,
so like the neighborhood?
And I was reading them, and I was like, crying, I was like, yeah, please do this.
Which
and
one are those?
I forget, it's in the notes somewhere. It's stuff about Buscemi.
But like, he spent a lot more time in Buscemi.
But the crux of this scene is about Los Feliz. Now, how do you pronounce Los Feliz?
Okay, so.
Bernard's got a little tidbit.
It's Spanish.
I read in this book about Griffith Park, and Griffith Park's part of Los Feliz.
No, it's not. It's Los Feliz.
That the guy who founded this whole area, his last name was Los Feliz, and the original name was Rancho Los Feliz. He was a Spanish guy, and that's the only way Spanish people say
it's true.
Feliz.
Like
so
Feliz cumpleaños,
Feliz
Navidad.
Happy.
By the way, this is actually our neighbor, Nicole.
Yeah. But if you say it Feliz, I mean, it's still a great place no matter how you say it. So, whatever.
Well said, Bernard.
But it gets better when you pronounce it more writer. Ain't that
so,
right?
More writer. Exactly. I want to go to this scene right here. This scene in the script was Bernard was going to improv it. And on the day of when we were shooting, we realized
the color wanted,
it needed
right?
to have some weight to it in the scene. And we did a variety of takes of this, even completely
some horrible
stuff.
Takes. Horrible. I did a horrible job.
Stuff. We did some more stuff. Just completely
check
different
out that lady.
And it just hey. I don't know how we came up with it just didn't work and that was the take we ended up going with because
I did.
It was the most depressed.
Sorry, I had to ask
yeah.
Wendy's currently at the Starbucks that I'm the, at the mayor
that you're always the that you're
yeah,
mayor on Fourth
Street
the mayor
call me back in yeah they really love me
the spaghetti in front of Wendy is actually the spaghetti we use in the scene so it's gross.
Well yeah it'd been sitting there
right
for how long.
God, I'm an idiot.
Ooh, you know what else is weird is Bernard wasn't even trying to start his car here. Those sounds were, they were added in, correct?
That's sound design, Steve.
That's sound design.
Sound design.
I'm learning a lot about it. Oh, shit, he's calling Stanford. I didn't think he was gonna.
Hey.
MIB3. Look at how many people.
Took care of my responsibility.
That was a big hit,
that's
huh?
That's great, man.
This episode was clearly shot later than all the other ones.
Yeah, we shot the rest of them in
January. I want somebody on YouTube to call us out. And be like, MIB3 didn't come out when you guys were shooting Venice.
I just don't want to be responsible.
I just want someone to like find something else that's dated.
Tell them to do that. Let it go.
This actually is the first thing that Bernard and I have shot with Will Smith, but hopefully not the last. Hopefully the last with Tommy Lee Jones.
So here comes the
run.
All right, on the big one.
Kevin Hinman, look out!
All right, here it is. There's our producer, Kevin Anacone.
And Kevin laughs.
Okay, the reason why I laugh is because right off screen, a girl goes, "Oh my God, did you see that guy just hit that guy? It was so funny, I couldn't stop from laughing." We only did one take, so it's not my fault.
Here's our place again.
And here's Eugenie's
really
scene. This is a really good scene, guys.
Oh, yeah,
a really good
yeah.
scene. Can you guys talk about it? Just. How we change things and
oh yeah.
Put the door down.
What are you two doing?
Well, we were gonna go to a movie, but Stanford said you left the stove on.
Yeah.
So the big thing of the scene is the button at the end.
Oh, I just
talked
to you.
And
you
Eugenie
here?
Had like a lot of different kind of endings. I was just telling, Eugenie. Yeah.
I just remember
because
Eugenie's
so good. Yeah.
Digging popcorn out our teeth. Come and hang out with us.
Eugenie's so good that I expect her to just finish scenes. So she's just like, okay. And then she comes up with this one.
Hey,
we're
Stanford.
Boning, right?
Oh, right.
Tell us about some of the other ideas.
Yeah,
you had.
We had a lot of good ones.
You had some good ideas.
Can you just share what they were?
No.
One of them involved a hand job in a certain amount of time.
Is it
about 10 minutes. Oh, it was 10 minute hand job. That's what it was called.
The process for finding the end of the scene.
It was just starting really dirty.
I was just weak. Pull from real life.
There you go, guys. You can turn this off now. Go to your rooms.
That's all you need.
I don't really remember. What
send
was that?
Send Eugenia a text, send her a tweet. You know, she'll probably...
Oogsy at Twitter. At Oogsy.
Yeah, we did a lot of different takes. I feel like we did a few takes that Kevin was laughing at, too.
There's a defeated man right there.
I was wrong.
That is a really funny cut from us, and then it cuts to Bernard just...
It went okay. He kept saying Los Feliz wrong.
You're saying it wrong. It's Los Feliz.
Not you two. It's Spanish.
Yeah, you wouldn't say...
This is a real, to people who don't live in LA, who don't know, this is a real problem that everybody pronounces as a different way, and nobody knows the right way except Bernard and I, who say it right, because we live here.
It's out there. It is out there now.
I gotta tell you, I lied to you earlier. I left the stove on.
What? You left the stove on?
A whole episode about leaving a stove on. The first time I told you that, you're like, that's not going to work, man.
Yeah, Bernard, if you lie about leaving the stove on, how are you going to be honest in your relationship?
I didn't tell me anything, you know? I was honest here.
She's telling me right here. You can tell her anything, because I'm sure she's probably told you everything there is to know about your relationship.
Set that up. Way to set that up, Steve.
I'm sure she's told you everything except whatever's behind the door.
This part, this scene right here, actually, this changes the whole series from my... From what where you expected to go. Just the introduction of this character.
Oh crap, who's this guy?
Oh, there's Adam McKay. With his hair.
Claiming he's back?
With wispy hairs in the front of his forehead.
Wait, Fig, she just told you could tell her anything, and she's never told you about this guy.
Oh man. I love that was Adam's idea too, to put the hair.
And why did she tell Stanford and not Fig?
I feel
let's
like
find
Stanford.
Out. Find out next.
Next episode. Thanks, guys. That's episode 5. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
That's
Thank
Go Nakamura, you. By the way. Go Nakamura.
Oh, go. I love Go.